Thank you, Director Templeton, and good afternoon, everyone. Now, that was a silent response. Good afternoon, everyone. For the benefit of our website audience, we want to make sure that we are energetic. Excuse me while I take care of the projector needs here. All right, good afternoon again. It's always a privilege when you're asked to recognize the hard work of others, and I have been given a short amount of time this afternoon to talk to you about Herculean effort on the part of many of you in this room and beyond in updating our obesity state plan and really setting a strategic direction for us in the coming years. As most of you know from our previous meetings, the South Carolina Obesity Council was established in addition to this forum to bring additional focus to our efforts around obesity prevention in this state. Director Templeton has already outlined some of the activities that we can already point to that are resulting from the energy of this group. And I want to highlight just a few more of those for you this afternoon. The Obesity Council really has a fourfold reason for existence. The first is to mobilize communities and public and private sector institutions around the cause of preventing and reducing obesity, but also to demonstrate leadership by providing a vision, message, and unity of effort around the core focus of obesity prevention. We also want to make sure that we're engaging all sectors of society through this effort, especially key decision makers who can work with us in making a difference across the various sectors of interest. And last but not least, we want to make sure we're promoting and endorsing only evidence-based strategies and programs that will make a measurable difference. Again, as Director Templeton was just outlining, we can already point to some of those measurable changes that have occurred, and that's giving reason for excitement to many of us who've been doing this for quite a long time. The work of the council involves more than 30 individuals who've come together to provide that leadership focus that Director Templeton envisioned in the beginning. But the work that is going on right now actually involves nearly 100 individuals from probably more than 36 institutions who are working somewhat behind the scenes, but involving many of you in the development of a new strategic plan for obesity prevention in this state. The highlights of that plan really are focused around many of the same things that our existing plan champions. Certainly the evidence-based approaches that are essential to making a difference in this effort. We are trying to focus, though, on strategies that we know are widely adopted and widely heralded, and through the Institute of Medicine's report on accelerating progress in obesity prevention, the report that was released in 2012, they have outlined strategies that have been adopted by the council in the effort of updating our plan, and we'll take a look at those more specifically in just a moment. The strategic planning effort that's ongoing is also intended to focus on engaging key stakeholders from across the state in the development of objectives and activities that will help to bring strategies to life over the next 5 years. Many of you in this room were involved in the development of our existing obesity plan, which was developed in 2005, and that was a 10-year plan. And we know with the dynamic nature of obesity prevention and the work that we're doing, that we want to have a focused 5-year plan that will at least guide us over the coming years and build on the important work that has already been done, certainly building on what many of you in this room have already done. The Institute of Medicine strategies, in case you don't keep them on your bedside table, are shown on the slide here, and they're ones that all of us in this room find to be easily acceptable in terms of promoting physical activity as an integrated and routine part of life, creating food and beverage environments that ensure healthy food and beverage options are the routine and easy choice for all South Carolinians, expanding the role of healthcare providers, insurers, and employers in obesity prevention, making schools the focal point for obesity prevention, not just with the emphasis on childhood obesity prevention, but also because we know that schools are a gateway to parents and families and all those who need to be reached by the message of obesity prevention, We want to increase the initiation, duration, and exclusivity of breastfeeding wherever possible. We want to make sure that we transform messages about physical activity and nutrition. And by this, I interpret it to be that we want consistent messaging that reaches all South Carolinians so that everyone in our state knows the importance of healthy eating and active living. And we also, importantly, want to make sure that we have adequate data and surveillance resources. And we have a lot of smart folks in this room and beyond who focus on that on a daily basis, and I'm grateful for all of them. And part of their effort is to not only make sure that we have accurate information, but that we disseminate that information and promote it, and that we also use that information to gain a better understanding not only of the prevalence of conditions that are of interest, but also the economic impact. As Director Templeton reminds us, this focus came about because she looked at the things that were most inclined to shorten the lives or diminish the health of South Carolinians, and what, if prevented, would save the state the most money, and certainly obesity is out in front. The work of the obesity strategic plan development is taking place across various settings, structured in somewhat the same way as our existing obesity plan, but with some expansion. And I think that it's important that we recognize the folks that are leading this effort. We have a number of work groups that are very active right now in the development of the new obesity state plan. And so I would like to recognize the folks, and if you're present, it wouldn't hurt for you to stand for the benefit of our web audience, and just to take a moment to gain some recognition for all your hard work. We have an early child care work group, and that is being led by Misty Pearson. No relation. But Misty, are you in the room or are you hard at work? All right. Outside, working hard. The schools and after-school programs are being led by Teresa Hill. Everybody's back at the office working hard, right? Okay. And then we have work sites being led by Phyllis Allen. I did see Phyllis Leary. Thanks, Phyllis. Faith Communities, Michelle James. Thank you, Michelle. Healthcare and Insurers, that work group is being led by Dr. Rhonda Hill. Is Dr. Hill here? She's also, okay. And then we have a community group, which is kind of an at-large group, being led by Lori Phillips. And I know Lori is in the room. Thank you, Lori. And in addition to these groups, we also have a data group that I believe is being led by Christian Gordon. Christian in the room? She is. Thank you for your leadership on that. These groups have been working diligently over the last few months, and they're continuing their work. As I mentioned, there are nearly 100 people involved and more than 36 organizations represented in this effort. So it is a significant undertaking for this group to examine the objectives and activities that are needed to make forward progress in these areas, and we have our thanks to offer to the folks who are leading this effort. This effort has intended impacts that will hopefully lead us to some outcomes down the road. We certainly want to increase the number, reach, and quality of evidence-based strategies to support both healthy eating and active living in various settings. We want to increase access and use of environments to support both healthy eating and active living, and then ultimately to increase the number, reach, and quality of both social and behavioral approaches to promote healthful eating and physical activity. Now, all of this is intended to lead us towards desired outcomes that are related to the population burden of obesity and chronic diseases. And these are simple outcomes, but they are challenging to achieve, and they're ones that many of you in the room have been working toward for a number of years. We want to increase physical activity as a routine part of life in South Carolina. We certainly want to see improvements in dietary behaviors and ultimately a decrease in the prevalence of obesity, and as we know, through the specific measure of body mass index. I do want to share with you, with that ultimate outcome in mind, some of the next steps that are involved in the strategy development process for the obesity state plan. Next week, a strategy planning meeting will occur on the 23rd, and if you haven't heard about that, you will soon. get details, but those of you who are involved in the work groups should already have it on your calendar. This is going to be a day-long activity where the work groups who have been diligently developing objectives and activities will come together to review those and to begin to report out to the broader group to gain feedback and to begin to refine that effort and to fill in the gaps, if you will, specifically to look at the responsibility for those objectives and where we need to look for leadership in the responsibility of making these things happen, to look at the resources that will be needed, the cost associated with the activities that are outlined, and the evaluation and data needs related to those. So it's important that we all work together to make sure that we refine the plan, because it's one that we will all use moving forward over the next 5 years. Throughout the spring, we will have further opportunities to refine the plan. Through March, April, and May, we will open up a comment period where those who have been outside of the development process will have a chance to review the materials and to offer comment, and also to gain input from the members of the council and other key informants from around the state. In June, if we meet our ambitious timeline, we will have a release of the draft plan and we'll be well positioned moving towards 2015 to begin anew our efforts around obesity prevention. And I do want to again recognize that there has been a lot of hard work by many of you in this room and beyond to get us to this point. We have another 4 or 5 months of hard work before us before we'll have a draft plan, but I am confident with the leadership of the folks in this room and with Director Templeton at the helm that we will have a draft plan by summertime. So thank you for the time to share this with you, and I will look forward to an open discussion later.